Hello, my friend! Today we're going to explore the letter D. Letter D. We're going to learn how to write and spell the letter D and a letter D word. Today we're going to explore a dog with the letter D and make a letter D craft. Can you think of any other words that start with the letter D? Those are some great ideas. Well, my friend, if you're excited to learn about the letter D, put your hands up, put your hands down. You can clap and wave your paintbrush all around, and let's make some art. All right, we're going to do some drawing and writing for the letter D. Can you think of anything, any word? Maybe an animal, it could be an object, anything that starts with the letter D. D says duh, duh, duh. What starts with a duh sound? Is there an animal that starts with a duh sound? How about an object or something you play with that says duh? Oh, I think I know some things. Well, there is a duck. That starts with the letter D. There is a dinosaur that starts with the letter D. And a dog starts with the letter D. I think we're going to draw and write the word dog. D-dog. Dog starts with the letter D. So we're going to practice writing an uppercase letter D. So we're going to do one line down. And then we're gonna go back to the top. We're gonna draw a curvy line around and tuck it and attach it to the bottom. Next, we're gonna do the lowercase letter D. We're gonna start with a circle and a line that goes beside it to make our lowercase letter D. D, dog. Dog starts with the letter D. So we'll do our line down, curving line around and attach. Og, d, d, og. Ah, ah, ah. It's not a sound, but I hear an ah, g, ah, g, ah. So we'll do o, d, ah, g, g. Do you know what g? What letter makes a g sound? G. Dog. Yeah, it's a G. So we'll do a circle and a line that goes down and curves back up. D-og. 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 Dog starts with the letter D. Next, we're going to draw a dog. Let's begin with dog's face. We're gonna start off with some zigzags for the top of dog's head. Let's draw a line that curves down, around, and up. We're going to draw a curving line on either side, up and down. Let's draw zigzag lines back towards the body. In the middle, Let's draw an oval for a dog's nose. Let's draw a line down from the nose. And we'll draw a curving line up on either side for making dog's cheeks. Below, let's draw a letter U for a fun little tongue sticking out at the bottom. And I like to draw a line down the middle of our tongue for tongue texture. On either side of the nose, we're going to draw a dog's eyes on either side of the nose. Let's draw a circle on either side of the nose. In each eye, let's draw a smaller circle, a smaller circle. And then we can color in the dark of the eye, leaving just that circle white. Once you're done, you're ready to color in your dog. You can pick your favorite art medium and choice of colors to color in your dog. Once you're done, your lovely dog is ready to play with you. Let's make our craft.
All right, it's time for our letter D craft. Letter D craft. So let's make our letter D craft. All right, we're going to make our letter D craft with a toilet paper roll. We're also going to need our scissors, our glue, maybe some tape, something to color with, and a duck color. Let's do a yellow duck. A yellow duck. So cute. All right, pick your duck color. It could be a white duck, it could be a brown duck, it could be a yellow duck. This is kind of a yellow beige, doesn't matter. We're gonna fold our paper in half. Landscape, also called hot dog. Yes. It looks like a hot dog bun, like that, if you have a hot dog in it. Next, we're gonna open our paper, and you'll see a lovely crease down the center. We're gonna use that to help us cut a straight line down the center to make a good piece of paper sized for a duck, or a paper duck. All right, we're gonna keep the other piece for now. We'll need it for our wings. We're gonna take our piece of paper and hold it onto our toilet paper roll. And then we get either a piece of tape or we can glue it. And just attach it on like that. So it's attached. And now we're just going to roll our toilet paper roll. So cute. Wonderful. Now we have a duck colored toilet paper roll. If I let go, it's going to unroll. So we need to tape it or glue it so it sticks like that. Perfect. Next, we need to make some duck wings. So I'm going to use that other piece. And I'm going to draw my wings on one side. I'm not going to do them in the middle. We're going to pick one side to draw them on. So this piece of paper is still good to use for other crafts later. We'll keep all our different craft papers, our extra scraps, in a lovely scrap paper bin. So they're good to use later. You can draw any shape for your duck wings. We need two wings for our duck. You can draw any shape for your duck wings. And then once they're done, you can cut them out. I'm going to cut this piece of paper off because it's still good to use for other things. So I'll just put it in my scrap paper bin. One wing. For my duck. So cute. Now this piece of paper, you can see the difference. This piece of paper can go in the scrap bin. This piece of paper is too small because there's nothing else I can cut out of it. So we're going to recycle this so it becomes something new later. All right, now we can attach our wings with either our tape or our glue stick. I'm going to use tape because it's nice and quick and it's flexible so they can flap when they move it. All right, one wing for my duck. And you can see because it's tape, if I move it, it flaps. So cute. That'll be perfect for when my duck needs to migrate. Go somewhere warmer for the winter. There's my other wing. And now my duck can fly when I move my hand. So cute! I love it! All right, duck needs a beak. I have this lovely scrap piece of paper in the orange color. So I'm going to draw a U shape for my duck beak because duck beaks are kind of rounded. Some beaks are sharp beaks. And some beaks are round beaks. Ducks have bills. We're gonna make a round beak with the letter U. And we can cut out our letter U. And this paper's still good, so I'm gonna save it. All right, look at that big duck beak. Attach it to my toilet paper roll. There it is. Duck beak. All right, what else does duck need? It needs eyes. Our duck needs eyes. Let's draw on some eyes on our duck. Nostrils so it can breathe. So I'm going to draw two dots on the top of my beak. Just like that. And once you're done, your lovely duck craft for the letter D is done.
All right, let's make our letter D painting. This part, you get to sit back, you get to relax, and watch me paint something that starts with the letter D. Can you guess what I'm going to make that starts with the letter D? Remember, lots of words start with the letter D. D says duh, duh. Can you remember a word that starts with the letter D? That's a great one. I love your ideas. You know what? I think we're going to draw a dinosaur. Paint a dinosaur. Dinosaur. Dinosaur starts with the letter D. Let's do a happy dinosaur. I'm going to start with the nostrils and add a mouth. Maybe I'll have some teeth poking out just below. I need to add my head. And I need some eyes on my dinosaur. Let's add a little tiny arm coming off the bottom. And we need a back leg. And a tail. Let's add a belly and connect it with another leg and arm peeking out in the back. And I like to draw them smaller so they look farther away. I'm gonna add some big tall vegetation or grass, or maybe plants. Because everything was much bigger back in the prehistoric eras. Let's add an ear and some stripes. And now we're ready to paint our dinosaur. So I'm going to find some fun dinosaur colors. I'm going to paint my dinosaur with a nice green. I'm also going to paint the plants and grass with green, but maybe a different kinds of greens. There's lots of different kinds of greens. There's yellow green, blue green. And maybe there's even dirt on the ground. So I can add brown. Or there might be dirt. Our dinosaur needs some stripes. And maybe it's a beautiful windy day, so we can use lines to create essence of the wind moving around us. And there's our dinosaur enjoying the lovely day.
Well, my friend, I hope that you had lots of fun learning about the letter D with me. I know that I had lots of fun with you. We explored the letter D and learned how to write the word dog and draw a dog. We also learned that duck and dinosaur start with the letter D. There's our little duck craft, and we had so much fun making it together. Well, that's it, my lovely friend, for this episode, and I will see you in the next one. Remember to let your creativity shine, practice drawing and creating all the time. And for more ideas for art for kids or online art lessons, visit ArtasticKids.com.